Welcome to the Center of Light Radio with spiritual teacher, intuitive, musician, composer, and best-selling author of The Divine Principle, Anchoring Heaven on Earth, your host, Keith Anthony Blanchard.
A couple weeks ago, I've been looking at Facebook like we all do. We're a bunch of Facebook junkies. I think we are social media a lot because we like feeling connected. Even when we're away from the social network of life, we go right back to socializing because we like unity. We like being together. That's a great, great thing. One thing I want to ask of those who are participating, be it on the stream or in the room, is from this point forth, thank you for your comments. But I ask, at least for now, until otherwise instructed, don't comment. Basically, if you want to ask a question and everyone's doing it, that feed moves so fast, there's just no possible way I will be able to address your question. I just won't be able to do that. So what I do ask is I'll use my intuition to pick certain people. I know the people that are in the room. I know people very well. I know the level of relationship I have with those people differently. So I can kind of intuit who may be having what and to what degree of it. And use their questions that might serve the question you were going to ask anyway. But also, you can bet at one point, I'm going to say, okay, girls, women, go ahead and ask you questions. Guys, ask you questions. And the reason I'm going to do it that way is so I don't get twice as many requests or questions bombarding the system so I can't keep up. So I've been watching Facebook, as I mentioned before, I'll get sidetracked. Lots of people have anxiety, and I was overwhelmed. I was freaking wild. And it resonated with me. It hurt my heart because I had it, and I know how much it sucks. And it is my goal. It is my hope. It is my confidence that by the time we come to the end of this live feed, you're going to be impregnated with lots of information that will change your life. All right, let's get started. Center of Light Radio fires off every Monday night, 6 p.m. Eastern Time, 5 p.m. Central for those here. I have phenomenal guests, and it costs you not a thing that can change your life. Very important. And I ask that anything I say here tonight, I'm not inviting you or asking you to believe me. That's the last thing I want. I'm not here to fix you because you're not broken. But the last thing I want from you is, you don't have to believe what I tell you, but apply it and watch what happens. You don't have to believe it. Just watch what happens. It's about being honest. How honest are you willing to be with yourself? It's about honesty. I ask you in this moment to just pause what you're doing. Put the popcorn down. Just pause and just relax. Just get out of stuff. Just place your, actually, shift your consciousness here. Imagine your consciousness is here. Just do it. Not hard to do. It's just your simple act of shifting your awareness into a different location. And so as you do that, be willing to be open and opened to receive what I offer to you, because it's your intention of wanting to take in that'll feed you, and then it becomes then it will blossom. It will become into fruition. But it's all about making the space in you available to receive it. Again, I'm not asking you to believe me. I'm asking you to hear me. I have a bunch of notes. I've worked on this all day because it's very important for me. If breath gives life, and life is not happening through you, then becoming aware of your breathing is your liberation. Become aware of your breathing is your liberation. Because breath, if you become aware as you in and out your breath, you will not be thinking. You will not be thinking. So breath is your liberation. If God, higher purpose, whatever you want to call it, I really don't care, breathe life into man, then conscious breath has to move said light through your body. And breathing will help expand you, and it'll help you become aware of yourself inside and as well as what's happening on the outside, even in places you can't even peripherally, places that you can only peripherally see or intuit or feel, this kind of thing. So breath and awareness of it is utmost important. And also breathing can help you move through any emotional trouble. Again, breath is life and breath is light and all that is good. It will dissipate the dark in you. Because once an event happens or a situation happens and the emotions go through the roof and you're in it, planted in it, and it's reality and it sucks, as you do the breathing, immediately start breathing your way through it. As, and the idea is it will dissipate that energy. Because if you let that energy sit there and you go to sleep and you let the energy sit there and you go to sleep and you do this ongoingly, then it becomes integrated and anchored in you. Then it's tougher to get out many years later down the road. Breathing will push you through the scenario just like that, and you'll be done with it. It won't become static or frozen, and it won't continue to give you trouble. Because if you do nothing about it, it's coming back around. Call it karma, reap what you sow, comes around, goes around. For every action has an equal and opposite reaction. Someone said I need to be a little louder. I will. So becoming aware of what's happening in you, and I don't mean just, oh my God, this is happening to me. Become aware of it. Be the observer and just be aware of it. Don't buy into it. It's not true. It's not real. The experience of what you think is happening is real, but it's not real. It's not true. Okay, let's keep moving. What I want to offer you through this event is you have to want it. You have to want it with every fiber of your being, because that is what will create the integration of the information on levels beyond understanding. That kind of opening to receive is intention. It all starts with intention. When you wake up in the morning and you go to your car because you're about to go to work, you're not thinking about it. But you are on some level intending that I'm going to get up, brush my teeth, use the bathroom, eat some breakfast, and jet out the door and get into the car, walk all the way to the car. That's all intention. But it's on autopilot. I'm talking about taking control of the wheel of your airplane itself. Then watch what happens, because now you become conscious and aware. Okay. And also, if you've guys seen many of my posts on Facebook, I often as a headline say, get out of the fight. Get out of the fight. Resistance goes nowhere. You have to allow yourself to be in the cosmic life stream. The cosmic life stream. There is a flow. There is no non-flow. You're either in the flow or you're not. So you have to become conscious of what's moving through you, around you, and move with it. And stop resisting the current. Because that is like the rocks in a stream. It creates rapids, turmoil, anxiety. And for you to become the master of your own ship, you have to use the compass of awareness. Internal awareness. Very important. Get out of the fight. Get out of the fight with your inner self. Get out of the fight with the world, your neighbors. If you have to leave a relationship, a married one, friendship, whatever it is, because there's a fighting, you can always change the relationship dynamic or the label of it. But the fighting is what's causing the problems. So that being said, one thing I've been really big on lately and was put to me in a very, very powerful way some years ago was by my mentor, Mr. Mike Matheson. He noticed that when he and I would dialogue, hey, Keith, how's your day today? Oh, man, I woke up, had some coffee, and I would go through every detail. And then I went to the store, and then I bought some Fruit Loops, and then I turned the aisle, and then I bought some tuna. And it was overwhelming to him. So because I was so hungry for spiritual awakening, I hung on every word he said, took it all in, and I practiced it. I didn't believe it. I didn't necessarily have to believe it, but I practiced it, and it changed. He told me, Keith, stop telling stories. What do you mean? He says, stop telling stories. You tell yourself a story every day inside your head. There's a story going on. You tell yourself one, and even when you're not aware of it, there's one being told to you because you're on automatic pilot. All the things we've learned, all the bullshit, this, that, religion, society, peers, authority, mom, dad, college, all that. It's just stuff. It's just a story. It's not real. Get out of the story. And also stop telling long-winded stories. This is very detrimental to your energy. The Chinese believe this completely. In fact, they would whack you with a stick on your ass if you are out of line that way, because they're congruent with energy. So the idea is story. And I will talk about story often, because the life that you are living is just a story. It's the story you are writing, the story you're creating. Your thoughts create your feelings. Your feelings create your actions. And your actions create the response. If God is everywhere, I don't want to make this about a God thing. I am not trying to convert you into anything. If you're an atheist and the word humanity or all that is good applies to you, then interchange it and use it. The point is, God is everywhere. I'm the present. Look it up in the dictionary. Present in all places at all times. There's no place it is not. Pretty simple. There is no story. The truth is everywhere, and you just need to be with it. A lot of the dialogue I'm going to have here tonight, now we're going to get right into the meat potatoes of, that was kind of like a monologue, I guess you could say. Now we're going to get into the nuts and bolts. A lot of this dialogue is going to come from my bestseller, The Divine Principle, Anchoring Heaven on Earth. Shameless plug, I know. I was in meditation for 8 years and received lots of things that were very wild, way out there, way in there for 8 years. And it was one of the most amazing periods of my life. The point is, I'm sharing this with you because a lot of the dialogue comes from this lifelong work. So now let's get down to it. Ask yourself, why do I have anxiety? Ask yourself that question. Don't judge any of your thoughts at all. Just become aware that the thoughts are there. They're just there. If you grab one, it'll anchor itself in you, and then it becomes reality. You can water the weed, or you can water the plant. Whatever one you use and water, it's the one that's going to grow. It's not rocket science. So why do I have anxiety? Just be aware of the thought or thoughts. Where does it come from? Where does it come from? It comes from within you. So that's where you must go to transmute it. There is no other way. There is no other way. Now I'm going to describe what I think happens to most of you who, unfortunately, have anxiety and or depression. Anxiety is worry about the future. Depression is dwelling on the past. Those two timelines, those two time local places don't exist. Right now is what's real. Why do you have anxiety? Why do you think that is? As soon as you wake up, even before you had time to start thinking, bad fear-based thoughts, it's already running behind the scene in like a script. Become aware of your thoughts, for they drive your feeling. Become aware of your feeling, for they drive your actions. Now, what you do not want to do is suppress your fear-based thoughts or be angry at yourself for having them. Just become aware of what is happening within you. And the light of that awareness will be your saving grace. God does not save you. Does not. Doesn't work that way. You have to save yourself. So why do I have these thoughts? Cognitive dissonance. Sometimes people hold a core belief that is so strong, when they are presented with evidence that works against that belief, the new evidence cannot be accepted. It would create a feeling that is extremely uncomfortable, called cognitive dissonance. And because it is so important to protect that core belief, they will rationalize, ignore, and even deny anything that does not fit that core belief. This is another variable that motivates people into bouts of anxiety. They're worried about the world, and it affects them greatly. It's kind of like being a slave to everything but being in control of your own life. Here's something else that I know that most of you have experienced. If you went to a hospital only to have them tell you that you're fine, go home. And you're here now, listening to me, hanging out with all these other beautiful people. You're not going to die. They already told you so. They're smart enough at least to know that. You're not going to die. So that should motivate you that if an anxiety attack happens to you, just remember that simple thing. Because why do we freak out and go to the doctor when we have an anxiety attack? It's because we think something's happening and we're going to die. So let's get honest. Let's get really honest about that. You don't have to feel awkward. You don't have to feel embarrassed. The reason we run to the doctor when we have anxiety, one, we do want to find out what the heck is going on, right? I get it. But after they tell us, there's nothing wrong with your heart, you're not going to die. That should be the foundation that starts the ball rolling in your absolute favor to bring you out of the anxiety attack. You're not going to die, at least right now. But you are going to die one day, and there's nothing you can do about it. Not a goddamn thing. Nothing you can do about it. So the things that you have control over, there's no need to worry, is there? The things you have no control over, there's no need to worry. Another way out of anxiety. Those simple things right there, what you can control, stop worrying. Concern, maybe, because you're responsible with your life. I don't want things just to go awry. But the things you have no control over, don't worry, because you don't have control over it. In fact, your best ploy is to let go of control. Let it go. But Keith, if I do that, I'm somehow insinuating that I don't care about my life and things are going to go crazy if I let it go. That is an illusion. Big illusion. Seemingly real. Nonetheless, it's not real. At all. You will have more control of your life when you relinquish control. Sounds ironic, doesn't it? It is, but it works. Because you will get so good at letting go of control, you will find yourself in that cosmic guiding life stream. It's that easy. And you may say, yeah, Keith, it is. You have to be easy on yourself. It's not hard. It's not hard. It's all about being easy on yourself and not identifying any longer with the thoughts and the feelings, which are a lot more denser, that convince you this has to be me. That's not real either. You as the constant awareness is what's real. If I was to ask you, what is this? You would say, well, Keith, that's your arm. Okay. But who is this me that is landlord of this arm. Who is that person? Same with you. That's really what you are. If you turn your head away for a moment from the camera, just do it. Just turn away from the camera. And as you listen to my voice, that ever constant, present awareness is the real you. It has always existed. It exists now, and it will forever exist. Think about that. I know you feel that. That's who you are. It's the constant present awareness. You, as the observer, literally seeing yourself, if you can, by shifting your consciousness above your body, if that's a metaphor that will help you. But see the whole world from that higher place. Water the weed, water the plant, and whatever one you will experience. You will start seeing the unity in the world. You will start seeing the unity with yourself and all people. Get out of the fight. Let's move to the next segment. Meditation is a way through your anxiety. You can't get out of your anxiety. You can only transmute it and dissipate it. And meditation is the key. Meditation is all about the here and now. You want to meditate? You want to learn how to meditate? You don't know how? Contact me. I have a meditation I'd love to send you. I would. Let's see. You have to become aware of yourself on all levels, your body, your thoughts, your feelings. And the more proficient you get at doing this, that will become second nature. Then you start feeling how expanded you really are. And now you have a new autopilot. Let me give you an analogy on control. If you liken the need to control as a wheel that spins within you this way, and it's spinning pretty damn fast because I live my life with control. But as you begin to relinquish control, that wheel begins to slow down. Once it stops, then things, and you will experience this. If you practice what I'm telling you, you will experience exactly what I'm describing here. Once that wheel stops, it's going to feel very, very funky because you're going to feel yourself falling-ish. Quote, like a rug being pulled out from under you. Hang tight, let it be, and find yourself in it and plant yourself in it and know that it's okay. Then the wheel's going to start moving this way. Back into the cosmic stream, you will consciously be. You will be trusting. Another way, you will feel the momentum of your life change. It's all about being aware and a master of the energy that's happening inside of you. That's it. There is no other gig. There's no other spiritual practice. There are different ways of worshiping, different ways to make yourself feel better and help the world or whatever it is may be. But that's the game. Become aware of who you are on all levels. That creates well-being. I suggest that you begin to look at all that you hold dear. The things, concepts, that you're clinging to are just your smaller self, we call it ego, seeking what it thinks it needs for happiness. Perhaps you still think that joy and your peace rests with other people. Or all your relationships the way you want them to be. I suggest that the next time you feel the overwhelming need to control, attempt to control yourself instead. Letting go through control, that sounds contradictory, but I tell you, it works. You may feel panicky at first, but not for long. I assure you, once you get used to this inverted dynamic, you will find your resistance and anxiety disappearing. All right, let's get real, y'all. Like, seriously real. And if you would, Anytime I say something, own it. Don't just listen. Own it. Tell yourself, I own that. That kind of witnessing between you and all that is good becomes recognized. It becomes acknowledged. The universal language is not English. The universal language is vibration. Okay? Own it. Question I'm going to put to you, a couple of questions. Just give yourself some time and answer. What are you so scared of? To die? Run it through your mind. Run it through that you're dying right now. You're dying. I can tell you right now, after this event, you will have died. Some part of you will die. Because there's nothing you can do about the information I'm giving to you. Nothing. In fact, you don't have to do anything. It's going to start taking over for you. You can, in fact, after this event, you don't go do it. You just go about your life. You don't have to think or remember about what I said. It's going to remind you. Get out of the fight. Just let it do its thing. There's no way out of this amazing maze. It will stop when you stop. You know, are you scared to die? Are you scared to be alone? Are you scared not to be heard? Are you scared to be judged by other people? Whatever. It's just scared. We talked about telling yourself story. Remember, if you're going to remember one, remember the story that's going through your mind. Are you seeking the need for approval? The need to impress other people. The need to always be right, dwelling on the past, resistance to change, negative self-talk, blaming others or complaining. I saw a post on Facebook yesterday. It said, being afraid makes the wolf bigger than he really is. All right, so realize that your fear is nothing more than that. This is from The Divine Principle, Anchoring Heaven on Earth, my bestseller. Your fear is nothing more than that. It's just a fear. Time and again, the mistakes that you have made by living without spiritual principles have perpetuated your fear cycle, and that has left you with all those feelings. Remember, whenever you buy into one of your fears, it's because you have a false sense of emptiness. Let me break this down for you. Do you have a fear of God, if that's what you believe in? Because some of the things you have done or not done, and that script is running in your mind? You could say that fear, F-E-A-R, is false emptiness actualizing reality. Fear. False emptiness actualizing reality. It's hyper-focusing on a situation. It's a space void of love. That's why when you have anxiety, it feels like this is shutting down or freaking out. And if the heart is a metaphor for love, and we point here for God, and we point here for love, and that's all many different facets in the metaphor of love, it makes sense that why when we have anxiety, that our heart is being attacked. Because we're attacking it. We're attacking our love with fear. It's false emptiness actualizing reality. Fear is a self-created block that constricts you and keeps you from becoming open to the highest version of you that wants to pour through you and bring you liberation and fulfillment. Let me see what time it is. Because I do want to take your questions. Let me scan through this, and then I know you may have some things that you might want to ask that are very, very important. And I do want to give you that time. Kathy understands fully. Good for you, darling. I'm happy for you about that. There's not a lot of us in the chat room, so if everybody would at least put one, just one question, if you have it, something that you want to ask, that you feel I haven't covered, particularly that would help you get to the next place. I'm glad you enjoyed it, Daniel. It's really just about being present. Don't buy into the bullshit story that your ego mind is feeding you. How do I get out of that, Keith? I can only put your hand on the switch. I can't make you flip it because I don't know how to do that. And usually it's just the want to jump off the air, out of a perfectly good airplane, trusting that the parachute's going to open and you're going to land safely. You have to jump. One, two, three, one, two, three, and do it. Just got to do it. What's the worst that can happen if you let go? How are things going for you now with the anxiety? That's a very honest question, and it deserves a very honest observation. What could happen if you let go? I think I have a question here. Let's see. I think, yes, right here. I try to meditate, from Melinda. I try to meditate, but my mind wanders. Any suggestion? Breathe, 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 breathe. Breathing gets you out of thought. Breathing also elevates your energy through the ceiling of thought. It'll push you through the ceiling of thought. And then you'll find yourself in the deafening silence of the cosmic dialogue. Praying is talking to God. Meditation is listening. It's not rocket science. We have to want to hear. And then there's noise. The devil and the angel, and they're both bitchy. We know the devil on your shoulder is devilish, but is the angel, is it possible that it's the same devil in disguise? It's all noise. It's mind noise. Breathe your way through the thoughts. Let's see, next question. What should people do to help themselves to be calm when fear strikes? That's a fantastic question. I'm glad you asked, because that was part of the pre-lesson just a minute ago I left out. We think that when we're afraid of something, the reason we are afraid of it, because we think that our fear protects us from that which we are afraid of. For example, think of a fear, and it walked into the room. However that would be, it walked into the room. And you see, you judge, uh-oh, and then you feel, And we use that feeling as a way to say danger, 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 flight, fright, fight, flight, fright, whatever that combination is. And so we go into that space. We think fear, our fear, protects us from that which we're afraid of. And that's an illusion. In fact, it throws you right into the trap. It's a big, juicy carrot that dangles right in front of your nose. And when you bite, it bites back really hard. So when fear strikes, don't strike the fear. That's watering the weed. You want to water the plant. Just be aware that you're afraid. Don't clamp down on it. Just be aware. See it, observe it, don't judge it, thank it. Say, thank you for being my guide and letting me know where I'm at inside of myself as to why I am boogered and bothered by this experience. That's it. Get out of the fight. Good question. Good question. Mine, Melinda says, mine wanders. No, gotcha. Christopher Lefevre, hello, brother. I asked my wife to leave after dealing with her addictions for 10 years. That was the end of December. Every day I regret, and it's filled me with anxiety. Bro, I appreciate you owning it in front of all these people. You are already transmuting that experience, and there's not a damn thing you can do about it. It's already transmitting right now, and you know it. You are dying. No more anxiety. You're dying. It's just a matter of just not doing the work. When you stop, it will stop. Forgive yourself, forgive her. Forgive the mistake, the mistakes on both sides. It's a lot of stuff, bro. I believe in you, dude. I do. All right, let's slow down the comments for just a moment. Abby says, I like your comment about anxiety. It's stressing over what hasn't happened yet. Depression is stressing on the past. Wow, that hit home for me. Good for you. Becky Reagan says, Keith, I want to remove any negativity from moving and leaving my 12-year relationship. I want to cleanse my apartment from any and all negative things. I'm in counseling, but I feel that I and my new space needs a true cleanse. You're welcome to contact me. KeithAnthonyBlanchard@gmail.com. Tell me in a more detailed way what's going on. We'll see what we can do. I love helping you. Okay. Melinda says, visit to ER Friday, anxiety. Back to Dr. Anxiety. I realize that. Again, it's these questions and comments are very well appreciated, and they are going to help other people. But they actually, now if you look at these comments, you will see it's the same situation said differently. Look, just thumb through the comments. It's the same mirror. A mirror sees one aspect. If you break the mirror, then you have a whole bunch of pieces, and every piece shows the whole. So they're all the same questions. Very, very good. I'm glad that people are owning up to it. It will change. And now everybody's plugged into the same consciousness. Everybody's in support of you. When they go to bed, this is going to be in everyone's mind. And this all gets released. And I'm telling you, your life is going to change. And you're going to post, hey, Keith, wow, thank you, thank you. You're welcome. But I like paying it forward. It's changed my life. And I'm obligated to do that. And there's no way I can get out of this ever. Brings me joy. All right, let's keep moving. Would like to know how to meditate. Trudy, contact me tomorrow, let's say, because I'm sure this is going to be a lot of stuff going on after. Contact me tomorrow, and I will send you my Anchoring Heaven on Earth audio meditation, okay? Andrea says, the clock is my enemy. I cannot be on time. This causes anxiety to escape the anxiety. Sometimes I just don't go to an event. You will now. You know what you do. You're just not doing it. Why? The question would become, and it's rhetorical, but ask yourself the question. Why am I consistently late? Why? What did you learn from? Who showed you how to do that? What is it protecting you from? What is your thoughts about why you do it on purpose and why you do it unconscious? Just look at it honestly. In the light of awareness, have you heard the expression, the light of awareness? It's true. Awareness is light. God is aware cosmically. God is the light. So even in your own little piece of mirror of the whole, your awareness is light. You don't have to do anything to fix it. Just be aware. And when you're aware of it, it changes on its own. You don't have to do it. That's why you're not broken. You're not broken. Okay? Next comment. Janelle says, good answer, Keith. You're welcome, dear. Let it go. Get out of fight. When something hurts, liken that to a live wire. So as long as you're grabbing the live wire, you will be electrocuted. It will shock you and it will hurt. Take your hands off of it. It stops. And you will find yourself moving it, literally moving inside. But this just hurts. It hurts. You're letting it go doesn't mean you don't care. If you have a loved one that has died, I get it. It sucks. You're letting it go. Hear me. You're letting it go doesn't mean you don't care. That's the illusion. You're letting it go means it stops hurting and it helps your loved one stop feeling like they have to hang around because you're not letting go. It frees you and it frees them. And now you begin to open the doorways within you that bring your loved ones back into your experience through your dreams, in your house. Even if you don't see them in that way, you don't feel that disconnect anymore. You just don't. You feel unified with your family unit. Okay? I would like to start learning how to meditate also. Randy, contact me tomorrow. Say, where's my meditation, Keith? I'll be glad to see it. Christopher says, you're reading me. Thanks, brother. You're welcome. I've been knowing you quite a few years now. Thanks, Keith. Let me know when you do more. You know what? I think I might do these often. Send me your suggestions. Hey, Keith, this is something I'm not necessarily struggling with. This is something I'd like to know more about. I get 5, 6, 10 of these kinds of posts about that particular subject. I'll make it my next week event. Great idea. Thank you, Renee. Hey, Keith, Patricia McIntyre. Hey, beautiful lady. Maybe you could teach a meditation class. I was asked that twice today. Deal. Remind me again, please. I'm not putting it on you, but just remind me again. Scott Whalen, brother, great comment, Keith, about you're not broken. Sometimes it's hard not to feel that way. Until you realize you don't need to feel that way anymore, brother. And you don't have to do this tomorrow. You don't have to do this right now. You just become aware. Watch it. Just be aware. Oh, my God, here's a big ball of mess. Yeah, it sucks. Ugh. And look at it. Just look at it. Without judgment, just look at it. Actually, see its beauty. See it for what it is. It's a gift from God saying, here, do you like this? And if he answers, I love it because it's showing me something. Wow. Versus, it changes the whole spin, the texture, the tone, the dynamic. It all just changes. All right, next one. We still got about another 5-10 minutes, okay? But I do appreciate here, while I'm thinking about it, I told you I didn't want anything from you. That was true, but that's changed. What you can do to help me, Center of Light Radio, which is about empowering people like you, and also empowers me, that can help its future, its now, is go to YouTube and look up Center of Light Radio. Subscribe to my page. Give me thumbs up on some of the videos that you watch if you like. If not, just give me some thumbs up anyway on some of my interviews, and leave me a comment and like every finger thumbs up that you see as you do it. It would mean a lot to me, a lot. Subscribe, comment, and thumbs up on my Center of Light Radio YouTube page. It would mean a lot to me. I'd appreciate it greatly. And always feel free to come to the radio show and hang out in the chat room. We have a grand time. It lasts an hour. Monday nights, great way to start off your week. Let me keep going. Meditation class, yes, yes, yes. Wow, everybody's saying meditation, meditation, meditation. Good deal. That's going to happen. I'll tell you what, we'll do that next week. Next week will be the meditation. I said if I got a few, then, and everybody's saying do it. It takes me. We are fixable. No shame. I dig it. Yes, meditation class. Good night, Renee. Take care. Kathy says, is it not on Facebook? The meditation, you mean? No. But I will do a live class. And we'll do it on meditation. Let me go through these comments once again. I think I got everyone covered as far as what you asked me here tonight. One more round. Everyone, give me one more question. If you have not had yours heard yet, but everybody give one more question. I'll go through them fast, quickly. And I absolutely appreciate you being here. It softens my heart. And it's not an ego stroke. It's not. I love what I do. And I'm obligated. So it means a lot. All right. Let's see. Okay. Mike says, missed the last 15 minutes. No worries, bro. This will be on my page, I guess, between now and eternity. As far as I know, live video feeds stay up there. So there it is. And I ask everyone to please share what I'm going to be doing, these bursts of light. Go back to that theme if I want. Light videos. Post them. I want nothing. Just share this with people that you care about, that you think might be open to receive such information. All right, let's see. We'll start from the bottom and work our way up, and then we'll sign off. Melinda, Todd, Clemens, take care now. Kathy, thank you. Center of Light on Facebook. Yes, I have a Center of Light page on Facebook, but also have Center of Light Radio on Facebook page as well. But I was speaking a minute ago about YouTube, my YouTube channel on YouTube at Center of Light Radio. Thank you, Kathy. She's talking about the Center of Light Bro on Facebook. If I still didn't answer that question, Daniel, contact me and give it to me in detail if I'm not getting the point. I'm with Sheila, guilt from what was done to me. If something was done to you, you didn't do it. The guilt serves no purpose whatsoever. It's self-detriment. Anyone want to do a one-on-one with me? I'd be glad to. KeithAnthonyBlanchard@gmail.com. Hey, Keith, I want the meditation. Hey, Keith, I want a one-on-one for this reason or whatever. I'm not asking you for anything, really, when I do these videos. But I also make a living with my life as to why I'm able to do such things. And if you want a one-on-one with me, I'll come up with a charge that's you're not going to find anywhere. And I'll give you content. I'll give you quality. And I'm with you forever. It's not because of money. It's just about I'm always here. So feel free, okay? Your music therapy as well. Thanks, David. That was great. Till next time. Thanks, Debbie. So do you need YouTube watched instead of Facebook? I just need some likes on my YouTube channel. It makes it nice and strong. It makes the listenership, the viewership greater. More, it becomes more visible to people in the YouTube land. So it has all those perks. So that means a lot. You can watch it on Facebook as well. If it's a YouTube link, it'll hit the same way. Dang, I missed it. That's okay, Tish. Blessings. It'll show up in the feed as soon as I'm done. Sheila's comment above. I'm with Sheila. Love you, my brother. Chris, take care. Hello, Dana Trotter. Thanks, Daniel. Thanks. I will get to all these comments. Let's see if there's any last ones. Sandy, I think as soon as I sign off, this thing's going to be live. Not live. Being able to be played again. Was great pun. Should I email you tomorrow? Absolutely. Email me tomorrow. Anxiety is disabling. Yeah, it'll kick your ass. But this new level of absolute awareness of what's happening, you're not the feeling, you're not the ball of mess. You're the observer watching it. Here's one more final trick, and then I have to jet. I would love to enjoy your lavender soul music. Thank you, Renee, you darling. One final spiritual morsel for you. Imagine, practice this, it's powerful. Imagine that you're just a ghost moving about the world. That you cannot interact with it. You can only observe it. But because you do live here, interact with it. But often practice the exercise of being a ghost. Even make yourself invisible. Invisible. I'm invisible. I'm just watching. You will see things you've never seen before. To different levels of seeing. Seeing. Practice that ever-present, constant awareness of what's moving inside of you, and your life will change. Jennifer, contact me. Next week, I'm going to make a show about meditation. I'm going to do these once a week. Love you, girl. Tell everyone in the family hello from me. I love you all. Peace, love, and light. KeithAnthonyBlanchard.com or centeroflightradio.com. Ease into bliss.